think we're getting right into it.
Three, two, one, go!
Alright, if you're just joining us, this is Smash 4, Nebulous Prime number 40. That's our brand new layout, giving us to the always awesome Knox. And this is the gonna be the last match of this bracket today.
Oh, I see the bracket.
Alright, Tito already racking up so much damage on PFG's Ike. Interesting character switch for these guys since they've been doing so well with their Mario and Luigi.
Yeah, I don't know. I like Leo's tag.
For Dark Blues.
Tito going super deep, almost making it back, but not quite.
Well, that's kind of evened out. He's not going to lose 5 seconds.
Alright, so I don't remember the exact record, but if PFG and Team Man are able to take this set off, I wonder if that puts them in a higher placing than Leo and Tito. Okay, so Leo actually putting in a lot of work with this Cloud. Not a character I really see him use too often, but...
I've seen a lot of it. I mean, typically you see one Cloud, you see
I don't know, I have to admit, I do agree that Cloud is one of those characters that's pretty easy to pick up, from what I can tell. I don't have too much fun playing him myself, but it definitely seems like you just learn how to really use stereos and keep people away. Okay, really good DI from PFG, able to get himself out of that typical Bayonetta combo. Nothing against Tito, I don't want to act like his combo is... I mean, it is kind of like a classic Bayonetta combo, but he was mixing things up.
He waited a little too... No, he did good time too soon.
Okay, so these teams are actually relatively even.
That's late.
Blue team has that slight lead of a stock.
Yeah, they need to get close as possible, but Leo knows how to hang on to Knox. So it's... I say that, but it's not an easy task by any stretch of the imagination.
Looks like both teams of the green team are at the least. Ooh, okay. Never mind. But definitely, these guys in the green team seem to know somewhat what they're doing when it comes to fighting Bayonetta. Like, they're actually DI'ing out of some of these combos, and, you know, punishing the right moves. Okay, so PFG making it back on stage by the skin of his teeth. Okay, and Diaz out of that combo again. Nice stuff from PFG.
Okay, no finishing touch from you. Do you know what angle is with Diaz? It's like down the way, right?
You know what? That's what I had been hearing, but now I've been hearing that for a lot of Bayonetta's combos, you can DI upwards. You know, thanks to E-Sam, of course.
Whoa, dude.
But that time, it definitely looks like PFG was DI'ing down and away.
I think what it is, if you go up and it's either up or up and away. What happens is when Bayo tries to land a second afterburner kick, you'll be too far up.
I think it's a little bit dependent on where you are and exactly where you're getting hit and what side of Bayonetta you're on. DI is a very tricky thing. I won't pretend to know too much about it. Won't try to give you guys any misinformation. But definitely
we only repeat what was told to us.
Yeah.
Is essentially it.
Definitely, if you guys want to know.
Don't shoot us. We did nothing wrong.
Yeah, definitely. We're at least trying to have a little bit of the right information about DI. But if you guys want to learn a little bit more about this anti-Bayonetta DI, definitely look up E-Sam's video on DI'ing out of Bayonetta's combos.
Shout out to the good man. We need to get him here. Okay. Going dank with Zelda. I say that, but they did take a game off numbers in Sinji last time he used Zelda. So I'm actually excited.
Zelda has got some moves for sure.
Just not enough Zeldas, man. This makes me sad. Even though she's like almost unanimously voted the worst character in the game, but come on.
She's definitely not the worst, though. I mean, come on, like, Jigglypuff.
More people use Jigglypuff than Zelda and get results.
True.
I mean, Jigglypuff is more used, but I don't know if Zelda's,
like, worse than
Jigglypuff.
She definitely beats out Falcon, at least. Just forward air or bear all the way off.
Three, two, one, go!
Okay, so T-Man switching to Toon Link, interestingly enough. Yeah, oh yeah, PFG is Link, so they've got kind of like the father-son combo, but not quite. I don't know. Alternate universe combo.
The question is, how well do you get this?
So, yeah, sorry, I just noticed that myself as well. I think we're both tired on this lovely Sunday afternoon, but we got...
Well, let's not let that detract from the action going on screen.
Yeah.
It's been...
The dank Zelda action.
I was just about to say, it's been almost a minute and a half. No one's died yet. Everyone's got 5%, so Link is down to that. If T-Man can just get... Alright, Clash, or not. If E-Man could just get a grab off the, on the far end stage, Babka will it be second strongest in the game, only second in this. Woo! That's okay, because PFG's got it anyway.
I definitely want to see Leo pull off some easy dank Zelda follow-ups and combos.
See, Link doesn't really have much of a kill throw. Okay, up throw can kill, like, at a reasonable percent, but...
Yeah, that's one unfortunate thing about Link.
You don't want to just go grab.
Unfortunately, Link has not quite as many follow-ups and options as you would see with Toon Link. But I think a team combination like this can still do a lot of work working off each other's strengths and weaknesses. Especially since both of them have similar moves, I would imagine either Link or Toon Link might be able to get follow-ups off of the other Link's bombs.
Well, that could work. Well, it's easier. Yeah,
Toon Link's bombs definitely allow for a little bit more following up.
I wonder if he's there, would it have connected and killed? Or connected, if he would have grabbed the ledge.
Okay, so green team down by a little bit, trying to make it back and avoid these dang Zelda combos. Okay, Leo is really going in hard for some of these moves. Okay, pretty safe right now though, just trying to see if he can trick T-Man into committing too much.
Oh my goodness.
Okay, and just like that, T-Man take a slight lead. They are both high percent.
They have
down.
To hold on to your stock.
Yeah, it's like, I don't know if you can call it a lead with a situation like that, and Link is almost dead on his last stock. But they do have 3 stocks to play with.
Either way, you know, just losing. Oh no. Oh, he's alive. By the skin of his. Caught the bomb. Oh, okay. That was
really
too
slick edgeguard.
That
Tito.
Was too soon.
What?
Why? He could have just tethered the ledge, but he used upbeat way too soon.
Yeah, just a little bit of unfamiliarity the character,
man.
There, maybe. Or, you know, just straight up anxiety fluffs. It happens.
Still sucks, though.
Definitely. Not how we want to see these guys go out, but either way, impressive performances from both teams. And we'll see what T-Man can do in this 2v1
right now. Toon Link is still
right
a very adaptable character.
And yeah, no, let's not forget, blue team, they're both on their last stock, so this is not an impossible situation.
Both of them also being relatively white. I think two of them have both. Oh, it just... Okay, he has to be careful, because Zelda's up air as of this patch got even stronger, so...
Leo's going to be waiting for him to commit to something like that. Yeah, I think at this point, Teammate needs to realize that Leo is going to be waiting for him to commit to something. Zelda doesn't really have too many fast things she can just put out or save things. Ooh, but Tito is going to get that up smash with the duck hunt dog helping him.
Round robin doubles.